So you may be asking yourself, why, Lowell? What are you doing in a wind tunnel that is mimicking Category 3 hurricane winds? Good question. So I asked Jule Barlow, the director of the Glen L. Martin Wind Tunnel at University of Maryland, College Park.
If you get a high wind, we would do measurements on things that need to withstand those winds without failing their purpose.
He explained that while the tunnel is traditionally used for vehicle aerodynamics, it actually helps with measurements dealing with roof systems, solar panels, and things that are fastened to buildings, and if they can sustain high winds during a major wind event like a hurricane.
Our challenge is to know how, for every case, to hold on to something so that we can do the measurement but not interfere with the airflow, so it'll be representative of the device in its operational state.
In this case, as I'm getting strapped up, I'm actually something that's getting in the way of those winds, as I have in real storms over the years. We start with a Category 1, which is a piece of cake.
All right, we're at 76 miles an hour, 80 miles an hour, Category 1.
Then on to a Category 2.
And we're just at about a Category 2 hurricane right now. Almost 100 miles an hour.
Then finally, as high as they will go, a Category 3.
All right, we're at just about an 111 Category 3 hurricane.
And from there, you get the idea. Well, it certainly is a wild ride. If you'd like to learn more about the Glen L. Martin Wind Tunnel, we've got some links on our website, WBALTV.com, and on our mobile app. At University of Maryland College Park, I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL TV 11 News.